Hello, HeartFitters. Welcome to a workout today that is going to strengthen and build your strength and muscles through your upper body and lower body. We're going to work on some good mobility exercises, particularly for lower body today, to help you with the ability to be able to remain strong, to do everything you want to do and need to do to aid strongly. We're also going to rip into some good cardio today. As always, I want you to go at your level. If you've been doing this regularly, I want you to up the ante. If you're just jumping in and trying our sessions for the first time, just ease in. So you can, even this workout goes for 1 hour, so you have the ability with recorded version to press pause and to click back when you want to, okay? So I commend you all for pushing play this morning, this afternoon, wherever it is, and doing this workout, okay? So our warm-up, let's just begin. I'll start with music, and let's get our blood flowing and muscles moving as we warm up. Just starting with standing tall, even engaging through your core muscles and swinging arms. Just start to breathe in nice and deeply as we open the chest up, like so. Open the chest and squeeze your shoulder blades together. So you can go left hand up, left hand down. Feeling good about the fact you're moving your body this morning or this afternoon. Good. Relax. Now, I want you twisting. I want you twisting your torso, and as you go towards that side, that knee up. Stand tall as you swing to the right and left with a high knee. Just taking it slowly. We're just warming up, guys. Side to side. Even look over your shoulder now, possibly. Rotate through that torso. It's engaging your glutes and your core muscles. If you are feeling good, you could go a bit quicker, of course. But it's still a warm up. Good. So as I mentioned, today we're going to do some lower body exercises. So I want you to warm up your lower body. I want you to get your feet apart. With any of our exercises today, I'll give you some heads up, but you could use a chair in front of you or a wall or a bench to help you with your stability. You're still doing a lot of good work for that lower body, but I'll show you this one. I want your hips going out. We're going to go towards, I'm going towards my right. As I do that, my right knee bends. My left knee is straight up, and I go down with my left hand towards my right shoe. And come up and change, okay? Side to side. Like this. I want your hips out. Not bending at the hips only. Hips out towards your opposite shoe. Side to side. The direction you're going, that knee is bending. Come up. Change sides. This may feel a bit uncomfortable. You'll feel the stretch through your inner thigh, groin muscles. Just take it slowly, take it easy if you're feeling a bit tight. Reach down. If you can, go to your shin and below. If you can touch your shoe, that's fantastic, or your foot. If you can't, just don't beat yourself up, guys. Just do what you can. Side to side. Give me six more. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Well done. Now, shake that out a bit. The next one is similar, but a little bit different. And we're going to have a feet wide again. I'll show you side on. So watch you from here. Hips go back, but you stay up with your hips here. Push down towards the floor. Then, hips go down as if you're sitting down. So we're going up and down, up and down. So you think about it, have your tail up in the air and dropping down, okay? Up and down. Like you're trying to touch a bench behind you with your butt, okay? Here to here. You're stretching through your hamstrings, the back of your legs, and your hips, and your glutes, your butt muscles, okay? Down and up. Keep the breathing going. Try and keep your chest up, looking straight ahead at the screen. Okay? 10 more seconds, guys. Give me 3 or 4 more. That's it. Nice work. Let's give it a march out. You've stretched through those muscles and joints that have been in the lower body. Now, I want you to do some standing star jumps. Everything in, everything out. 1 foot goes out, hands go above head. If your shoulders are not great, you can do this kind of thing, okay? You can just go chest high. If this is not good for you, you can go here, okay? Now, if you want to, you can continue, or you can even try a few of these. Star jumps, okay? Light on the feet, on the balls of your feet. If jumping is not good for your body, just do standing stars. Breathing in as we get the heart rate up. Blood flowing. Let's enjoy. March it out. Our final move for our warm up is a skip rope, a pretend skip rope. I want you to have your arms going like you're moving your skipping rope, and you can just march if you like, reasonably fast marching with skipping rope, or you can even, if you can jump, have a jump. Let's go for 20 seconds. Watch my world crumble, sometimes it eat good. You live and you learn. Come in with the lions, the tigers and titans. Afraid to get hurt, but now I'm making them hurt. I got fire in my feet, and I'm feeling in my heartbeat. Breathe it in. Oh, you can't pull out these legs. You can't keep me out of my seat. I got fire in my feet, and I'm feeling in my heartbeat. 5, 4, 3, 2. That's my tip. I'm recommending the breaks. As when we stop, and as I show you the next exercise, I recommend you breathing deep in your belly and breathing out. Inhale, exhale. It helps you to recover and get ready for the next exercise, okay? So, today we've got some exercises we're doing first. Round one, we're doing everything for 30 seconds, and we're doing everything twice. So if you find it a bit challenging to get it right, the good news is you've got 2 guys at doing it, okay? At your level, I'll show you what you can add in load-wise or just go body weight, okay? Second round, when we do that, we're doing 20 seconds only, and then it is all sitting down on a chair, okay? So have a chair available. Best is to have your kitchen chair is best, because it's nice and narrow, and you can move your body either side. Lounge chair, you still do some, but it's not as easy. A kitchen chair or something like it is ideal, okay? So, first one is a lunge. We did these in our warm-up, but I want you to add a little bit to it. I'll just show you what we're doing here. Let's move a bit my gear. So, I want you to, we did the lateral lunge. So, first one, is 30 seconds, we're going to go to one side. I'm going to my right. So once you're stepping towards that one direction, doesn't matter which way you go, that knee, that one is bending, this one is straight, stand up, and come up with a high knee. The chair or the couch or whatever you have, a bench in front of you, is for your stability. Okay, you can even do it in front of your lounge, have your hands here, bending, high knee. So when you come up with a high knee, you're working on your balance muscles, okay? Those stabilizers, so they can help you remain strong. Falls prevention, okay? All this stuff is for lower body, assist your falls prevention, okay? So we wanna make sure we work on that regularly. So, bit of music. And I'll start the music first, and I'll start the timer. Okay. For 30 seconds, guys, we're going in one direction and a high knee. And go. High knee. Step. High knee. The knee bending as you go towards the side. High knee. Stretching through the groin, through the hips. Working on your balance as you come up. Use your chair if you need to. 5 seconds. Nice work. We've got 20 seconds to recover and get set to change directions. You might move your chair or just turn around. Stepping the other way now. I'm going in 5 seconds. And go. Bend this knee. Brace your core. Nice work. Now, this next one is a what I call a standing crunch. So instead of getting on the floor, we can do a crunch, working our abdominal muscles and our hips standing up. Two hands above head, you can even clamp something like that. Standing tall, I want you to swing alternate legs. Straight leg kick. When you come up, crunch your through your abdominals. You could add a dumbbell if you want to add a dumbbell for load. Like this, I'll show you side on. Your goal is to get your foot up to hip height. If your balance isn't great, feel free to use a chair or a wall on one hand, okay? So there's always a chance to progress or regress. Ready for 30 seconds, standing knee crunch. Leg crunch. And go. Resting for another 15 seconds. We're going again, team. So remember, when you come down here, think about crunching the abdominal area, okay? We're starting in 5. Round 2. Go! Nice work. Good work. So, next one is a push-up. So, we've done push-ups regularly. Today I want you to do a push-up with a bit of a twist. If you can, I'll show you what we're doing. You can use a wall, a bench, a table, a chair, whatever you use, make sure it's solid, it's not gonna slide. Okay, so wall's pretty good for that. So, we push up on the wall with our body nice and straight, elbows bending, push back, rotate one hand. Okay, so you're working through your core again and working through the strength on the shoulder. If your body isn't good with this wrist extension, just modify it, okay? So If you can do a push-up rotate, that's great. If you need to modify it, do so. I'll show you the version on a bench. We go down, we push up, and we rotate. We go down, push up, other side, rotate, okay? You can even do it on the floor, on your knees. It's not an easy exercise down there, but some of you are that well advanced, okay? So you can choose your options. Wall, you can even use a chair, but make sure your chair is stable, okay? Push up, rotate, okay? Let's have a go at it. 3, 2, and go. Push up, rotate. Push up, rotate. Chair, the wall, the floor. Push up, rotate. Guys, 3, 2, 1. Not easy one, that one. But it's there to challenge your upper body strength. As I said, build muscle, retain muscle mass. If we don't use these muscles, we unfortunately lose them as we age. So let's go again in 4 seconds. Are we ready? Down we go. Halfway here, 15 to go. On a wall. Nice work. Shake that upper body out. Shake it out. That was all upper body. Now we're going lower body again. This is challenging. It's a progression. I'll give you some options. It's a curtsy lunge. So with a curtsy lunge, we push back. My right leg goes back behind my left and we curtsy. Remember the curtsy, ladies? Okay, we're on the same leg. Now, that's too challenging. Options, you can just step back and lunge, or you can have your chair or your with you. You can have your hands on the chair as you go straight back or into the curtsy, okay? If you can go low, that's fantastic. If your hips aren't great for it or your knees, just step back. This is challenging your balance muscles anyway. It's really good for your balance. Dip a bit if you can, step forward. Use your wall. There's so many alternatives, okay, if you need to. Let's do it. Full range or even whatever you can do. 3, 2, go. Same leg for 30, we change over. The curtsy, lunge, or just step back. 12 to go. This will make your lower body stronger, guys. 4, 3. Nice. Just note, I want your front knee back from your front toe. Okay, we're gonna change it up. Let's see how my knee here is back from my front toe. In 7 seconds, guys. 5, 4. Go. Step back, step forward. Curtsy if you can. Changing legs. Breathe in as you go down. Come up, breathe out. Ten seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. Nice work. That's not easy, that one. Shake those legs out. Now, we've done a fair bit of upper body and lower body. Now we'll do some cardio. So, we're doing 30 seconds each side. I want you sitting up, have a bit of water as you like, as I demonstrate. So, two hands here or a dumbbell here, This leg stays stationary, front leg stays stationary. This one is pumping towards. Push off your ball of your foot as fast as you can. It's a sprint, it's a race. As fast as you can, guys, okay? Working hard. You could use a dumbbell to pump that knee forward. Just be careful, if you do use a dumbbell, don't bang it on your knee. So, ready? 30 seconds. Go! Can you go faster? Ask yourself, tell yourself. Okay. 12, 10. Nice work, your heart rate's up. You wouldn't notice that the stationary hip starts to burn. It's fantastic for you, enjoy. We're changing sides, you ready? 4, 3, go! Pump it past, pump it! Halfway, keep it going guys, you can do this. Nice work. Have a sip of water. As you do. I'll do the same. So. And this one is back into that lower body strength wise. So, options again. You get to step back and kick. On the same leg, the idea is a step back, which again challenges your balance, like this, and kick. If you are able to or want to have a go, you can have a lunge. Chest up, chin up, knee here, and kick. Feel free to use a chair for stability or a wall to hold as you go down, okay? Same leg, step back and kick. 3, 2, and go. I want you kicking with a bit of intensity, a bit of sass, a bit of attitude. Lunge, kick, lunge, kick, or step, kick. 6 seconds. Nice work. Shake it out. We're changing sides, of course. Ready? To go again in 5 seconds. Changing legs, step back or lunge. Go! Halfway team, step back, kick, lunge, kick. You can do this, come on. 10 seconds. Alright guys, relaxing. So now, we've got three more of these 30-second rounds to go. This one's a side step. So working on the lateral movement and strength again, I want you stepping over to one side, other foot follows. Step, follow. Step, follow. This is the easier option, less challenging option. We're still working on that inner thigh muscles. If you're up for it, you want to challenge yourself. We start low and we step across into the half or three quarter squat, okay? Side to side, staying low. You might go low for a few seconds or half the time or whatever you can, and come up and shake it out and go again, okay? Staying high or going low, it's up to yourself, but try and challenge yourself, Tim. Go. As far as you can, one side to the other. Foot follows. Stay low if you can. There's no jarring, so you're not going to damage anything here. We're just working through those muscles and joints. 10 seconds to go. Nice. Take 20 seconds to recover. Of course, we're going again. Your heart rate's up. We're going in 8 seconds. Get yourself set. Tell yourself a good story. You're doing this. You're happy. You're positive. Go! Can you stay low? Shake it out. Breathe it in. Have a sip of water. As I demonstrate, you're recovering. The next one is an oblique. Your obliques are here, either side of your body, your side abdominal muscles. We work them by doing this today. We're going one side. Elbow down, knee up. I want you to crunch here, okay? We've all got these abdominal muscles. If you can't feel them or see them, it's of course got a bit of a doona over the top of them. But they're still there, okay? Trust me. Okay. Stand tall here, and we're crunching to that side. Your knees out to the side, elbow meeting, okay? We're trying to touch. Crunch. Ready? Go! And crunch! And crunch! Taking 20 seconds, changing sides. Deep belly breathing. So good for your hip mobility and your obliques. Okay, this is your last 30 second round. 2x30. This one is called a mountain climber. This one can be done on the floor, on a wall, on a chair, on a bench. So, let me demonstrate. We're here, body straight. We pump our knees in as fast as you can. If you can, it's like a run action, okay? It is easier on a wall, I mean a bench, or a 900 high kitchen bench. It looks like this, if you can, okay? Pumping those knees. My hips are down, pumping them in. Like a running action. Or you can use your chair, like this. It's all about getting your heart rate up safely. Still working through the hips as well, okay? We ready? Mountain climbers, let's go!
When all the tears rolling down your face, and it feels like yours are the only heart to break, and when you come back home and all the lights are out, and you're getting used to no one else being around.
Halfway, keep it going!
Oh, I'll be there when you need a little love, I got a little love to share. Yeah, I'm gonna come through.
Welcome to Mountain Climbers team. Enjoy. Just to make sure you got it right, we're not doing it again in 9 seconds. Let's do it. Get yourself set. Go. Halfway, guys, keep it going.
When you still can't feel the rhythm of your heart, and you see your spirit fading in the dark.
Five, four.
I'll be there. When you need a little love, I got a little love
to share. Well, that team, that's great cardio. Let's have a breather. We're gonna have 2 minutes to recover. As you have a bit of water and do some deep breathing, tell yourself, I'm a little bit over halfway. I'm enjoying it. I wanna keep going for maximum benefits, okay? So, as you recover, I want you to grab yourself a chair. Ideally, as I said before, a kitchen chair or a chair, similar, so you can maneuver on the chair. Here, you could use dumbbells, bands, and that towel I spoke about, okay? We're gonna use more of that stuff from this time on. So grab your gear, have it ready. I'll give you a moment, I'll just adjust my timer myself. So we're doing 20 seconds work. I'm actually gonna give you 13 seconds to recover between, okay? And a bit longer if I have to demonstrate. So 20 seconds, we're doing everything twice. So, are we ready? The first exercise is going to be, I want you sitting back in your chair, nice and straight like you're a good student, and want you marching high while sitting down, okay? That takes a bit of effort. It takes more effort than you think because you're engaging your core muscles and your glutes, your butt muscles, to make that happen, okay? While you're doing that, I want you shoulder pressing as well, okay? You can do double hands like this and march or alternates, okay? It's up to yourself and find your level. Go hard if you can. Great exercise, no jarring in the body, okay? Breathe in, breathe out, sit up nice and straight. Let's go for 20 seconds, guys. We'll have music going first. And go! Find it! And smile! Two, one! Nice. As I said, round one, you get two chances. If you're not so sure about the first round, second round's there for you to really indulge. Express yourself. And go. Well done. So, now, next one, we're gonna march again. This time we're gonna rotate our torso. I want you to punch side to side. You can have dumbbells if you like, okay? So high knees, again, that's not easy. And so when your left knee comes up, your right hand goes across it, okay? So it's that twisting action, working through your core, working through your hips, and there's so much going on in the lower body, okay? Enjoy the ride. And go! Nice work. We're going again, team. If you feel a bit uncomfortable or uncomfortable, that's all good. It's part of the fun. We go. Nice work. Recovering as I demonstrate the next one. So, this one is sitting up nice and straight on your chair. Leg, I want you to straighten your leg, alternately. I want you to squeeze your thigh muscles. There's four quad muscles. Squeeze, release, okay? As you come down. While you're doing that, you're doing a chest fly. Open the chest up, body weight looks like this. So we're doing this every time you go up. Okay? If you have dumbbells, this way. If you have a band, hold the band here, pull it apart as you go out, okay? So upper and lower body strength. You might find you feel dominated by your upper body strength, think about that, but also I want you to think about squeezing those thigh muscles, okay? 20 seconds starts now, we're away. Body weight. All the dumbbells. Squeeze those thighs. Four quad muscles. Resting, ready to go again, team, in 7 seconds. Deep belly breathing. Go! So now, you can bring your towel into action, if you have a towel. So, this one you can use a towel, you can use a band, or you can use dumbbells, okay? So, we have our sit up nice and straight, it's a heel dig. So from here, I want you touching your heel on the floor. As you do so, you take everything out. Hands out, foot out. Change. Out. In, out, in. So we're getting a bit of coordination work here and you're using your brain. As you get into this, try and go faster, see if you coordinate everything together. Out, in, okay? Dumbbells, bands, you can use dumbbells, look like this. Out, in, or a band, the same, okay? Are you ready? And go. If you have a towel, pull it apart. Engaging muscles. Out in. Go fast if you can. Well done. As I said, if you have a band or a towel, pull those apart so you're engaging the muscles. We're going in 5 seconds. Go. Bit of volume. Faster, if you can. Well done. Okay. Now, I want you to visualize you're in your boat, you're in your kayak, you're in your canoe. Okay? I want you to do some rowing. Knees close together. Bend. Pull apart. And row. Elbow high, so you row strong. Okay? Transfer the weight left and right. Your towel is the same. You pull it apart and you row. Dumbbells. You have the dumbbells together. And you row elbow high. Okay? Work through the core muscles. It's a great exercise, guys. Visualize on the open water. Beautiful Hawaii. And go! Recover. In 5 seconds, guys, we're going again. Nice work, guys. Excellent. So, now, we've got three more of those 20 second rounds, and then we're gonna finish with a round of Tabata, which is a good bit of 20 second action fun to finish with, 4 minutes of work, okay? So we're doing well. Now, next one is a pull down high knee. So you can use your towel again, or your dumbbells or your band. Once you're pulling that towel down, or the band's down, or the dumbbells, high knee, okay? If you're feeling good, you can go fast. If you're feeling like, oh, I'm struggling, just back it off. It's your workout, okay? So, are you ready? We're going for 20 seconds. Go! Pull and pass. Deep breathing. We're going again, team, second round. All these dumbbells. 3, 2, go. Think about his knees going high. Come down. Think speed if you can. Okay, next one is equipment free, no equipment needed, so just make sure you got a bit of room. If you're feeling a bit sweaty, have a towel off, a bit of water if you need it. Now this is what I call a seated star jump, seated stars. So we go out and in, so your feet go out, hands go out. If you have bad shoulders, you can just do this. If you can though, above head. Or if you're really keen, you could use dumbbells here to go above your head, but just be careful not to bang them on your hands. So, we ready? So, we go everything out, everything in. Okay, I find this a bit of fun. The quicker you go, the crazier it is. Okay, enjoy the action, cardio, and moving through the core. Go! How fast can you go? Who would have thought you'd have so much fun in a chair? Or so much hard work? 5 seconds, guys, you're doing it again. We'll be right back. hope your heart rate's up like mine. So, now, as you recover, I demonstrate. Last one for this round, before we start on Tabata. I want your hands here. You have two dumbbells if you like. I want you twisting through the abdominals, twisting. As you do so, the side you're going towards, that knee comes up. Even look to go over your shoulder. It helps your mobility. Even when you're driving, the ability to look over your shoulder. We're working on that sort of action and a lot of other stuff as well, okay? Twisting, high knee, towards the side you're going towards.
When we're dancing on the ceiling, oh, what a feeling. When we're dancing, well, it's high.
You can even pull the band apart here, have it here, close, or dumbbells, I'll use a band. 3, 2, go!
Oh, what a feeling, when we're dancing on the ceiling.
Nice work, team. Have some water, shake everything out a bit. You've done well. I'm gonna give you around about 2 minutes rest here, because we're gonna finish. I'm gonna bring your heart rate back toward normal, to where you're pretty much well rested. We're gonna finish with 4 minutes of high intensity, if you can go with me, okay? If you can't, as I've said many times before, just do your own level, enjoy moving your body. As you recover now, I'll show you what these four exercises are. In this workout, we haven't done many squats. So let's do some squats, but I'll give you an alternative. So we're doing two lots of squats, 2 by 20 seconds. I want you to think about getting your hips down to knee level or even touching your chair and coming up quickly, okay? So it looks like this side on, we push hips back in that nice deep squat area, which really works maximum benefit for those muscles and joints. Now, if a squat is no good for you, you can do this sort of thing. Elbows high, opposite elbow, opposite knee. You're still engaging the glutes and your core, okay? So that's the alternative if the squat isn't for you. Then we're doing an agility step. I want some room wherever you are laterally. So I want you to march across a few steps, wherever, how much room you have, and back. Now, if you'd like to, you can up the ante and make that a run. Doing it quickly, okay, side to side. Agility sprint even, okay, the second one. The third one, there's three options. You can work on some star jumps or star steps, or you can do it as we just did, sitting down. Sitting stars, or if you choose to, you can do some push-ups, okay, without the rotation. If you want to work your upper body, you can work on some push-ups, okay? There's three alternatives, sitting, standing, or push-ups, okay? And fourth exercise is boxing. Dumbbells are ideal. I want you to punch down for 4 punches, punch up, okay? When you're punching, transfer the weight left and right, go with speed, okay? Using the whole body. And it's great for the heart rate, okay? That's the four exercises. So I'll give you about 2 minutes rest there. So, are you good to go? I just had a bit of water myself. There's 4 minutes left, guys. 8 by 20 seconds, okay? With the rest, it's a bit over 4 minutes. So, let's see what the music here. Ready? Let's start with our squats. If you want to challenge yourself, see if you can get 15. I say 10's a pass, 12's a credit, 15 plus is a distinction. What can you do? Nice work. If you're not doing squats, you're doing this one, okay? We're going in 4 seconds. 3, 2, go. Well done. Okay, breathing. Next one is lateral agility. Stepping or running or jumping. Don't do jumping. Running. As per today's routine, we're going again. Same one in 4 seconds. Halfway, guys. Okay, now, standing, jumping, seated, or push-ups, guys, you can choose. Okay, in position. Star jumps, seated stars, or push-ups. 3, 2, and go. Or push-ups. 5, 4. Recovering. You've done 5 by 20. You have 3 to go. One more standing stars or push-ups. Or seated and then some boxing. And go! Okay, let's finish with some boxing. 2 by 20. Dumbbells down for 4, up for 4, or body weights, okay? Okay guys, well done. This is the last 20 seconds coming up. Last cardio effort for the day. Then we have a stretch. Okay, let's put the effort in. Go! Last 20! Well done, guys, we're calling it time. Excellent work. I suggest you grab a water to start to bring the heart rate down. Some nice deep breathing. We'll have a stretch. I want you to grab your chair available so you can see the screen. Let's have a seat. So hopefully as you start to stretch, you start feeling those happy endorphins. I call it the after exercise euphoria. So you can sit down, I'll just stand up for a second and show you a few of these. Elbows, back, stretching through your chest. You can even close your eyes if you like. Breathe in deeply and release. So you open up your chest and squeeze those shoulder blades together. So hopefully you might feel a sense of accomplishment, maybe a sense of relief you've got through. Maybe you didn't press pause. If you did, that's fine, but you've worked out. Fantastic. Release. Now, in your seated position, let's relax. I want you taking your ear towards shoulder, side to side, side, side. Nice work. Just relaxing. Take a moment before you get back into whatever you're doing next. Just take, don't think about that yet. Stay relaxed, stay in the moment. Now your chin down towards your chest and back as far as you can, just within your range. If you feel discomfort, just don't take it too far. Nice relaxation, release of the neck muscles. Two more. Well done. Now let's come across your body. Shut the gate with your arms. Stay seated as you come across. Elbow goes in, forearm goes in the elbow. Through this shoulder here. Bring your arm in as close as you can to your upper body, to your chest. Good work. Release. Change sides, across and stretch. Well done. Continue that nice deep breathing as you recover. Tricep stretch, triceps to the back of your arms here. Put over the back of your head and pull it across diagonally, stretching it through here. Sitting down like this. Well done. Release. Shake those arms out. Change side. Good work. Now, lower body, we're gonna do some hamstring stretching. So I want you to come to the front of your chair, put your foot out in front of you, make sure you can see me. Slide your hand down your leg as low as you can. With the leg locked out, can you get your fingertips down towards your shin, your ankle, your socks or your shoes and beyond? The further you go down, the better, guys. It might feel a bit uncomfortable, but feel a good stretch. It'll help your mobility and maybe reduce lower back pain. Hold, 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 breathe, 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 and release. Change legs. Slowly, take this stretch down. Fingertips to your shin, foot beyond. Nice work. So that was pretty behind your knee mainly. Now we're gonna stretch up higher if you can, up and in this region. One knee out of the way. This leg here, reasonably straight, maybe slight bend. Palms towards the floor. So you're looking to stretch up higher. If you can't feel it up higher, push back in your chair a bit, which will make your leg a bit straighter and go down further with your palms towards the floor. Nice, good stretch. Good, release that one slowly, change legs. Down we go. Stretching, stretching. Good. Sit back in your chair now. Put your foot up on your knee. Pull this knee towards your shoulder, across. Stretching through this glute in your hip, around your hip region, okay? Feeling good now, aren't you? Because you've stopped. You've released everything. You've got your heart rate back to normal. You're feeling good. Push it down. This one is for the glute as well. How far can you get this knee down? Level with the other knee. If it's tight, just feel it, release it somewhat and release. Change legs. Over and pull. Nice. Push it down now. Good. Now, our thighs, the front of your legs. We can do this one sitting or standing. Stand up version is grab one foot, stand up nice and tall, okay? Now, if you have hip or knee issues and that makes it very hard, simply sit on your chair, on the front of your chair, foot back and lean back, stretching these four muscles in the front of your leg, the thigh, the quad, okay? Either way, lean back, stand up tall. Good, release. If you're standing, change legs, sitting, do the same. Lean back. And our last stretch is the calves, the lower legs at the back. So I suggest using your back of a chair or a bench. Your leg is straight at the back. Push your heel back on the floor, leg straight. Slide hips in towards the chair. Stretching up here. Nice stretch. Top of the calf. We're going to stretch the lower calf next. Okay, stretching. Now bring your foot forward, knee bent. Both knees are bent. Heel back on the floor again, slide in towards the chair. You should feel this one down on the lower calf, okay? Achilles tendon, lower calf. This is an excellent stretch. You're helping your mobility, you're walking, lifting those feet, getting stronger. Change legs. Push back with your heel. Leg straight, slide in. Nice. Last one, bring your foot forward. Nice stretch down lower. So well done guys for joining me today on this workout. I recommend you, in your recovery, you take in plenty of water to hydrate yourself. And it is good to have a little after workout protein, whether it be coffee or whether it be a lunch with an egg or some ham, just to help build your muscles and build your strength. Okay, so well done. I look forward to seeing you next workout. Bruce from HeartFIT signing off. Cheers, have a great day.